from by this
protest. No, the president will never receive.
But why does
the government? Well, people know, you see, people cannot begin to, you know, to politicize this genuine, the integrity of this cause. This cause so pure. The purity of this country should not be. What we say to you is that the president have allowed, you may have allowed that the gender minister, government official team, people started jeering at them. It doesn't solve it. It doesn't help this issue. Like our mothers came here. So we can't do it. So the president is very passionate. As I speak to you, the president has initiated two DNA machines. It has now happened in this country. We've been advocating for rape that was 17, so that you can be able to establish a fast track the case.
Mayor Koji, why is the president refusing to come meet with the protesters?
The president would never refuse. What I understand is that the petition will be received. The president is a lover of his people. He understands what's happening. First of all, what I want to say, I condemn the first way the police, you know, I condemn the police. We should not beat anyone.
Thank you.
No one should be beaten. People should be protected. So I think they are young people. The only reason is that these people become victims because they have genuine quest. It's not political. This is not political. I have a sister.
Sure.
You may have a daughter.
That's not
even though I'm desperate to have a girl child so I can be able to protect her. I don't have to see. So we protect our girls.
I'm not dressing.
When we were advocating for rape, Vava Gevlo was then the gender minister. We were kids. Vava Gevlo, we honor my good friend Phil Dixon. We did not boo at Vava Gevlo. We were excited. We received Vava Gevlo. At that time, when you were Jeremiah Pia, were also a civil society person at that time. So when you are an advocate, vote of political persuasion, what you do is that you allow policy makers. The only reason sometimes we resist them, if take example that Jefferson Koji is a member of this government and he engaged in a rape, you know, he's engaged in a rape and the government is refusing to take action, then we become non-compliance to them. We insist that the president deal with that particular government official who will ensure that that person God is facing the law. That is not the case in this country. No government officials currently is being faced or charged with rape.
So, okay.
So what you can do,
the government, plan
the, government the government responsibility is to work along with you to find solution to help and protect our vulnerable kids. Let us not politicize. This country has gotten so polarized that every other thing can be politicized. That is not the point.
Mayor,
when you talk about politicizing, you have come in the interest of our children, of our sisters. It means that we have compromised, which of course we are not politicians, but it's just that we want the right thing to
that's
do.
All.
So what I want to say is that pertaining to the quarter that spoke this morning from Prime FM, what you have to say about Maruba Maru reporting that he put out about women and girls being abused?
No, that can stop. People hear more. People hear more.
Mayor, let me come to you first. There is one loud voice that comes from this grouping, 3 days they've been protesting, calling for justice, and that voice is capital punishment for convicted rapists. Share with us your thoughts. Do you support capital punishment?
I feel as a former activist who have a protracted history and advocating for youth and students in this country. What I can say this year to you, I have two views towards that. My first paramount view, I support adequate education. I think the issue, take for example, when you begin to take away people's life, it doesn't bring solution. Take for example, some people could be victim. People could be victim. The victim is that they could be lied on. If that person is killed, it doesn't solve the situation. Another aspect of my view, I support worst case scenario, chemical castration. If the man is guilty, you must chemically castrate him so he lives and he becomes, you know, functionalist. He doesn't use the organ anymore to, you know, to inflict casualty. So that is my view. I think that's the way we need to do. But I think we need to put emphasis on more sensitization. We need to ensure that our courts can begin to start fast-tracking. Who are advocating our greatest challenge of all in the court? The court have been. Because sometimes you don't know, just after the first 2-3 weeks, when the cases, you know, when the temperament go on, what the judges will do is that they will go in front of means and loopholes and allow these people to get back into the community. You see, that is our challenge. That is our challenge. When I was advocating, our greatest challenge was, the greatest challenge was to ensure that there was a leakage within the judges. Know your staff, don't create, stop it. Yeah,
yeah, sure.
Thank you. There are more people here.
Thank you, Mayor. Thank you.
Thank you so much. So let me say to you, we want, I would say the president is his full support, and we hope that the president, as a young person, I strongly believe that your effort here will be worldly appreciated. All we want is that the president should constitute a national youth task force, a task force that will be surely run by social civil society. Young people who can be given the opportunity to go into the community and begin to sensitize, because solving rape issue begin at the community. We must begin to set, go honor the churches, go honor the church, and set to the people and begin to tell them that look, this attitude is wrong. Once the people are not educated, you know, tradition, all these things. That's why I brought 22 plus mayor intern. As I speak to you, there's a workshop currently going on at the Memorial City Corporation. We had a press conference, somebody here, even in Papalu. The Papalu mayor is here where you have the situation. You know what the Papalu mayor said to me? That we need to investigate. He said the case people are talking about, yes, indeed, it's happening. But that issue of a racial play was not true. You see that? But everybody said it was true. But he was there. We must get the actor, the leaders. So we must bring them on the table and allow them to help us solve some of this issue. They are not our enemy. What you're doing here, that's a genuine and pure cause. We respect it, we support it, it become foolhardy that we will be here as government official. Only you don't have a child, only you don't have a mother, only you have a sister. That's it. So I want to say to you, it's something that we very, very appreciate. Thank God, see Kula for final year. When we were advocating, they were kids, you know, we inspired them today. You see Kula, the person, our history, not behind the house. I can name more 1,500 young people here who said the tongue from the fountain of our knowledge. They were inspired by our role in this country. So you can defend us. You may attempt to make us violent. You may attempt to look at us evil. But our consciences are very clear. And people who know us know us for the same. So let me say thank you so
what
much.
What is a vision to start the rape cases in Abuja?
My role is what you see me doing. If you're in my office and come in here, and I tell you, I could have said my sister, everything okay with you. Great. So that is it. So let me talk to my woman here. Yeah.
Okay, Morovel City Mayor Jefferson Kochi just appeared here and was in conversation with the journalists, and other protesters were throwing questions at him, and he was there providing information as it relates to what the government is doing to end the culture of rape in our society. This is Spoon TV, we are live, coming to you at Fish Market. My name is Haji Masale, And the broadcast continue as we get more scenes of people coming to endorse this end rape campaign in the country. Okay, just a moment ago, that was there was information of some people believe to be supporter of the government came and had a little clash with the anti-rape protesters, and you can see some of the protesters dispersed. But this guy, a sad talk going on, as you can see the guys.
It's wrong. Thank you.